The mixture of the blood that flowed through his veins had killed his conscience and filled him with shame. He was part white, part black, part red. That's how he got the name George Leroy Chickashea. He had no respect or feeling for anyone, including himself. He resented every man. In his soul, there was no salvation. And he hated the sight of cotton fields and his thoughts of plantations. The bitterness set his soul afire when he'd think of Indians and reservations. He had the coldest gray eyes I've ever saw on a man. He could look clear through you and back again. And they looked like pieces of stone when he'd stare. There was a mixture in the texture of his hair that hung low around his cheekbones that were high above his chin. I saw him kill a man with his own bare hands, but show no mercy to him. He carried a pistol, a switchblade, and a tomahawk with him night and day. The meanest man that ever lived, George Leroy Chickashea. He had the quickness of lightning and could run like an antelope. He feared no man, no gun, or rope. I saw him watch a rattlesnake bite him on the leg. Never batted an eye. Then he said, get a taste of that blood. Crawl out there and die. They locked him in the security cell in Baton Rouge. He stayed one day. Iron bars couldn't hold George Leroy Chickashea. At last he gave himself up and said he was tired of running away. So they spread the news that they'd hang George Leroy Chickashea. He walked up the 13 steps to the trapdoor and stood on it with no expression in his eyes. And when the minister asked him if he wanted to pray, he looked toward the skies and said, God, inside my veins flows blood of red, all mixed with black and white. I have no race or creed. I pray to die. George Leroy Chickashea.